What's up, 2K fans out there? Today I'm doing my wish list. Been procrastinating, taking my time, and all kinds of nonsense. Today has come. It's time for that wish list. 2K17. As you see, this is my Boston Celtics team. If you're new to the channel, I have four teams that I play with. Let's go ahead and look at my whole court. Four teams that I play with: Boston Celtics, Indiana Pacers, Phoenix Suns, and the Denver Nuggets. I'm like, wow, that's a lot of teams. Yeah, play with four so I can keep it fresh. Playing with one team gets boring since you can't move. You can't go from different team to different team. So I had to pick four. So I think that would be like my number one wish list for 2K17 is have the ability to switch teams. Like in the old 2K, I believe it was 8, 2K8. There was like, they had this option where you could change teams in the middle of the season, right? And the only way you could do that is if there's were teams that were sucking and they wanted to fire a coach. And it was certain teams, so you couldn't just go pick whatever team. They had like maybe three or four teams that you can play with. And you could switch. And that's the only way you could switch. I mean, you can switch in the offseason and all that, but the whole point is that you could switch teams. You can't do that now. So I was doing a little practice. I'm going to show you. Go ahead and jump into these scrimmages with this team. But yeah, like I said, I'm going to show you all four of the courts. But this is the wish list. So I say my first one that I would like to have is been able to switch teams, having that option of switching teams during season or after season. You know, after you've taken a team to the playoffs, maybe you want to move up or whatever. That's one. Let's see, another one. I had a list, so I'm gonna just ramble these off the top of my head. I'm gonna talk about each one for a little bit. So, on 2K16, they introduced the ability to make these courts and relocate arenas and change logos and all that craziness. But they forgot the fact that when you change your logo, when you change your logo, you don't have the ability to have that logo appear on a cheerleader's chest or in the crowd. So like when the playoffs come, when the playoffs come, everyone in the stands are wearing white t-shirts, not even white, but they're just wearing white t-shirts. And that's so that needs to be fixed. That's not real major, but it's an, you know, I mean, it's 2K17. And like I said, oh, snap. Every time 2K adds some things, 2K always taking away a couple of things, or they forget a couple of things. What else? Netflix. I'm streaming. Let's see how this post move. There we go. But like I was saying, every time 2K adds some things, they take away some things. So that's an ugly eyesore. I mean, it's not nothing, like I said, too major or that's gonna break the game or anything like that, but just an eyesore. Once again, All-Star game. All-Star game. So you go into the year 2020, right? And you're still playing at the same court for the All-Star game when it came out the first year. There should be an option of creating an All-Star court, something, or being able to switch arenas. You should be able to do something. Is that not, if there's an agreement not to do that, or why can't we add some skins to the court to make it say different things? So that it's not the same court every year, even though, oh, snap, there he is. There it is. And then, ooh. Oh, he got blocked. But the All-Star game, just the court, should be able to change the courts from time to time. I should be able to see a different court instead of seeing the same court in 2017 or in 2018. It shouldn't be the same. Back him down. He's small. Hook. That's another thing. So all the things that I'm talking about is all for like my league and my gym. Those are the only two modes that I really get into. In-game stuff, like when you're in a season game. I don't know how long I've been talking about this, but game 25 should never feel like game 63. And what I mean by that is that the crowd should, like, you should definitely feel like this is, you should feel like the playoffs are about to start. Especially if you're playing for seeding in the play, trying to get seeds, trying to get that home court advantage or whatever. You should feel that difference from game 20 to 62 or whatever. Division games, you should notice a big difference. Or at least rivalry games. And maybe they should add like a have a touch where they can add that feel of a rivalry game. Maybe you can throughout the season, let's say you're playing someone, right, and the first game, so you play, ooh. Ah, that should have been an alley-oop. That first game that you played them, you know, it was close. Second game was a blowout. And you played this team like four times. So somehow that should become a rivalry game. Or if you have a player on another team that's like been killing your team, but then you get a superstar. That you should be able to get a rivalry badge or something. Like the game, you should be able to develop rivalries, and then heated matchups. And you should the game 20 and game 60 should definitely feel different, especially when it's coming up to playoff time. The commentary should be putting more emphasis on the games. They should definitely be talking about what's going on around the league, especially when there's dead time, like in between timeouts, free throws. So, I mean, if you played the game, you know there's a lot of dead space when the commentators are not saying anything. Like they'll say something during the timeout, and then that's it. They won't say anything else. That little space right there could be talked about. Oh, left him open. He ain't gonna hit it. He hit. That little time could be talked about what's going on around the league. Not stats-wise. I'm talking about standings and what's happening that night. You know? Let's back this dude up. Oh. Force that. But that's one thing that I've been talking about for the longest. The crowd needs more juice pumped into them. Ooh. Crowd need more juice pumped into them. This practice mode, like so. So we got the training session where you can train your players and do all this craziness stuff. Oh, that's ugly. Practice mode. You should be able to, like I'm doing right now, give little boosts to your players. If you can come in and do a 5-minute practice thing, or like play a game up to 21. Like that's what I usually do. Play a game of 21. Leak out. I thought somebody was dying. They should get a little boost, depending on how well they did in practice. I think that would be major. That would add something new to the game. Actually make this mode right here useful instead of just feel like I'm wasting time doing this, or it's not important because you got the team training session. So practice mode needs to have more emphasis on it. Can I get a... Yeah. Get some. We played a 21. So you should be able to select if you want to play 3 minutes or play a score of 21. You know, ooh, left them wide open. And just different things should be affected. So you play the game, and depending on how your players plays, different things are affected. For you get just a little boost. Not something major, but a little boost. I've always thought that should get them. The fade. Oh, Noel. Win by two. What else? The champion should be referenced. Nice rebound. The champion should be referenced in the following season. There it is. Game. Oh, that's game. 21-19. Win by two. The champion should be referenced. I just want more commentary, you know, better commentary. I want practice mode to mean something for the season mode. Just like a little boost, five points to something, offensive awareness or team chemistry. Team offense awareness, team defense awareness, you know, just something like that. As you see right now, my Celtics are 19-14. Let's go ahead and jump into this Phoenix scrimmage. I want to show you the courts. But all that should be fixed. So I'm going to show you this court real quick. And then I noticed that when you make the courts, and if you pick the arena where you have the announcers tables, and it's broken down into three sections, and there's areas where the fans can sit, right? So with the created arenas, you never fill those spots up. They never get filled up. Never. Like, they never get filled up. If your team is above 500 in the playoffs, those seats are sitting there empty, just empty for no reason. And you're in the playoffs. Oh, I don't have it at this arena, but as you see, here's my arena for the Phoenix Suns. Grand Canyon State. That's a nickname for the Phoenix area. Well, for Arizona, actually. And then the Valley of the Sun. So with my Boston team, I had Beantown right here. And then City of Champions. That's another nickname that they call Boston. So that's what I came up with those. But here's the design for the court. Right here, I did the Western because I don't have that option of picking something that's original and won't look like out of place. I wish they had templates for arenas. Like, so I'm remaking the arena. I should be able to use the arena that is the arena name that has been that sponsors the Phoenix Suns. I should be able to take that and still plaster it. I don't want to use something from the community and all that. I want to use what's given to the arena. And then up here, I want to use something else. But, you know, that's all we got. I feel like I should be able to change the color or something, just make it a little bit my own. But as you see, this is my arena, Jimmy Buckets. Give me another one. There we go. I'm happy that they did the customization for the give you more hands-on, but they also handicapped us because they locked up a lot of things. You know, they locked up a lot of things. Like I said, if you change the logo at any or do anything to the logo or the color, it messes with the cheerleaders' outfits, the fans' t-shirts. You don't even get your city's name on the t-shirts. So it makes you not want to do anything because you don't get that you don't get that feel that all the other teams are getting. So what else? I would like to see more attitudes, more personalities when you're in these games, especially when you're playing a division rival or a star player versus another star player and they're guarding each other and they're going at it. Like, you want to see that. You want to feel that. You don't feel that in a game. You don't feel that. You don't feel that emotion, you know? Like, watching the game, you see that, you feel that, you get hyped, but you don't get that while playing the game. And I think they should figure out a way to boost the personalities of these players in-game and get the crowd behind it. You see, I got Nick Van Exel. Nick Van Exel. That's Bucket. He's too small. Nick Van Exel. I feel like the league is, like Tracy McGrady said, watered down. So I added some of these players. Oh, stolen. What are you doing? Like Shake said, Shakedown said it the best. It seems when you pass a person a ball and they're in the open court, some invisible wall or some invisible shoestring or tree stump keeps the player from freely moving. 2K needs to remove that nonsense. That's not real player movement. So I don't know who they got doing motion caps that's doing these. Ooh, look like his leg almost came off. Oh, nice. Oh, what the hell, Pat? Get the rebound. Push it, push it. Oh, my bad. There it is. Oh, he was about to yoke, turn into a layup. But I hope they improve the player motion stuff. No more invisible walls. Player movements need to be more crisp. That's my fault. Ooh, Devin Booker. Leave him open. That's all day. I feel like they need to create another badge for role players. That's bad. Get back up there. Oh, see that right there? That shouldn't be like that. Or maybe they should have a, ooh, let them open it. A quick reaction button. Because in the league, if you get a rebound, most players are going right back up, quick. He holding them. Bucket. Oh. Stolen. Oh! Big man pushed it. But there should be a... There shouldn't be no hesitation. Should be able to go right back up. And you can't go right back up. Should be. Oh, nice, 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 nice. My Phoenix team last year didn't finish too well, and Lilio was injured for like 3 months. Yeah. So he was injured for about 4 or 5 months. They didn't make the playoffs. But the team got them. Got some good players around him. Nick Van Exel. Lost to Rajon Rondo to free agency and picked up Jimmy Butler for a trade during the draft. And that's another thing that needs to. I guess there's not much you can really do during the draft time. Or to make that more exciting. Oh. Get him. Come on, Nick. Come on, Nicky. Should be more fouls. Oh! Different types of fouls, different types of ways to foul. Who remembers that NBA Live? running down the court, right? On the 64, that's what I played it on. Running down the court, press that triangle button, left. Oh! Quick hands, DJ. Nice. Let's slow this down. Let's go. Bucket. Oh, come on. Come on, D'Amelio. Come on. But you can push people down, you know? That's not nothing too major, but I would like to have the ability to do that, just run around instead of trying to. Oh. I think that would. If you were able to do that, that would add some more attitude to the game, some more emotion to the game. You would definitely see more flagrant fouls called. And I guess that would. Oh, my goodness. What's wrong with your handles? Ain't nobody moving. Golly, move. Everybody standing still. But that would definitely add more emotion, more personality, and more flagrant fouls to the game, especially during playoff time. Like, and that's another thing. During playoff time, there should be a more intense environment. Yeah. Let's go. What was that? I don't understand that. Why does that happen? He got kneed. Push. Hey, see the practicing. I swear I've seen the practice seems much more physical than the in-game mode. We've seen like 6, 7 fouls, people going to the hoop. Should have went to the hoop. I mean, the game is good. I'm happy they finally added a ticker bar. You know. Ah, man. Lost them on that. But the ticker bar should be in-game mode, too. The ticker bar, I should be able to see that during the game instead of just, because there's so much information going on the, dang, that dude got quick hands. So much information on the screen. I'm trying to read other stuff. Ticker bar should be in game, and like I said, the commentary, Greg Anthony and Kellogg Clark should be talking about that. They switch. Coaching personalities that needs to be adjusted. Remember in EA college football, if a coach left. Oh! Ooh! Lock C. Ooh, go up. Bucket. Oh. She just fired it from the. That's the all day. Oh, he open jacked it. But yeah, in college football. Wow, Nick Van Exel, your handles. What is going on? College football. Man. College football. So the coach would leave, right? Go to another school. And you could definitely see his playbook being played at that school. So with this 2K game, right? They made the ability, if you haven't noticed it, they've made the ability of players turning into coaches. But the only, there it is. Oh, come on, Danilo. First team about to lose this game. Oh, no. Oh. But the playbook, you could definitely see that coach's playbook at that team school. I'm cheating right now. They ain't gonna call no 3 seconds or 5 seconds anyway. Oh, he ain't gonna shoot it. Oh, first team looking shaky. There it is. So like not Kevin Durant. It was Tim Duncan, right? Tim Duncan retired, got picked up. He's a coach now. So I'm interested to see what type of playbooks he's running. I know Andre Miller retired and he became a coach. And I'm playing with him. No, I played against him and the playbook he was running. I don't think he would actually run that in real life. Ooh, that should have been blocked. To me, he seemed like he's a more of a slow it down, half court. There you go. Half court type of coach. But he's running something else. But most of these coaches ain't running their playbooks on the game. So I feel like they should definitely implement the coach's playbook and actually run the coach's playbook. Oh, wow, got left. Good D. Fouled the mess out of him. Eyeball. Win by two. They should add more coaches to the game. You know, before the season starts up, find out who's gonna play. I mean, who wants to be coaching? Got him. Nope. Oh, Nick. Stolen. Oh, good steal. Jimmy in the. That's game. But they should add more coaches to the game, like real life, the real coaches, the ones that want to coach. It should be added to the game, so when these coaches begin fired mid-season, they're not finding these random name dudes and putting them in the game, and then they end up getting fired 3 months later. It's so lame. They could definitely do better than that. I know they can do better than that. Here's my other team. I'm gonna show you their court real quick. Go back. I didn't even edit their court. I forgot about that. I messed up. It's my fault. So now we gotta sit through this loading screen. Golly. But anyway, add more coaches, have them sitting, waiting for whenever a team get fired, they can just jump right in. Add a playbook for the coaches. Actually let them implement their playbook into the team and actually run that playbook, that playing style like Mark D'Antonio. He likes to get the ball up the court, shoot less than 7 seconds off the shot clock. I should be able to see that in game. So he got hired by the Houston Rockets. That should be happening. As soon as they get the ball up the court, the shot should be going off. You know, we already seen this before. That's nothing new. But yeah, Tom Thibodeau, slow it down, grind it game. Half court set, defense, defense. You know, the old Spurs, Greg Pop, right? He used to play the same way. It was just recently where they picked up the offense and made them run more, started getting more points. But old Pop, grind it down, half court set, defense, slow, boring Spurs. Nobody wanted to watch them in the playoffs. That should be implemented into the game. So selecting a playbook, you should be able to select a playing style and you should see it. Who else? I probably should just jump straight to the Pacers. I think I'm wrapping this up. I'll probably just do one more, but if anything else pops in my head, I will definitely tweet it out or make another video or just drop a line in one of my other videos or something like that. But I mean, the game so far, 2K is way better than EA. They've been doing a lot. They've been trying to listen to the community a lot more, adding things. But like I said, EA will add and then take away. As you see, this is my Denver team. You know, creative player right here. Uh-oh. Like, that's ridiculous. Clear basket to the hoop. I'm pressing turbo. Moving forward, Hassan Whiteside takes a jump shot. Don't know what that's about. I'll be switching. Picked up Klay Thompson in the free agency. Hassan Whiteside got picked up in the free agency. Buckets. Net didn't even move. Got Tristan Thompson off the free agency. Then was trying to make a big splash, trying to get into the playoffs. Had Dwight Howard. I traded him away. Who did I get for that? Actually, yeah, traded him away for Klay Thompson. Golden State let him go. Oh! He's switching. Oh, snap, I beat him to the spot. I should get, like, a vibration in my controller when we're going to switch. I mean, it's not like I can communicate to my players on the court. They can communicate to me that we're switching. I see the little arrow, but that's a little bit too late. I should get like some type of vibration. Open. Get like a vibration left or right, the little thing should move and let me know that we're switching. Stolen. Let's go push. Yeah, just little minor things. I mean, like I said, the only things that I like to focus on is my league and, oh, nice spin layup. Oh, Klay. Go, should have been a steal. Oh! Oh man, didn't know what I was gonna do with the ball. The home screen should be more, I don't know, something. I think I'm just nitpicking now. Oh, picked up the dribble. Nice cut. Oh! Golden. There it is, wide open. First team is a beast. Second team is kind of weak. But, out of bounds. For drafting, or for, like, putting new players into the draft or whatever, I would like to see them come back with the thing where you could edit these players throughout the year. There it is. Oh, come on, Tristan. It's early bedtime right there. You better not score. He ain't got that. It's crazy. He don't shoot like that in the game. Oh, he stripped him. Trying to be fancy in the backcourt. Oh! About to cost him the... Uh-oh. 16-19. Let's go. There it is. Ah, oh, go back up with it. That's what I'm talking about. Come on, son. Ah. Oh. Come on. Let's go. That's game. There it is. Right now I'm just rambling. No. I like 2K. I like what they've done. Just like I said, little things here and there that I want them to improve. Most definitely the All-Star game, garbage. Tired of seeing the same old court over and over again. That's annoying. Let's go ahead and show you this court for the Indiana Pacers. Tired of seeing the same All-Star court. Tired of dead spots in game. Talk about what's going on in the division. Talk about what's happening in the playoff seedings, you know. Add some more badges, role player badges. You know, players that come off the bench and know what they're going to be doing. I Like if you got a 3-point specialist, right? He loves being in the corner. You should see him no matter what the playbook is. You should see this dude constantly running teams to get to the sidelines. You should constantly just be seeing that dude running back and forth to get to the sidelines. He wanna be in the, he wants to get open. Constant movement. People who like to rebound the ball, crashing the boards, hardcore. Pacers court, you see that Crossroads of America. Nothing too fancy. Got the parquet. Naptown. People who from Indy know what that's about. Naptown. PG-13 right here. Game. Ooh, not quite. There it is. Size. Yeah. But this one didn't have it either. The three sections. But anyway, like I was saying, with the three sections on the scores table, there's a section where fans get to sit. That's never filled. Put some people in that area. Put the color of the team jerseys, the team colors on the t-shirts, and put the logo on the t-shirts. Stop being ridiculous, 2K. Get it together. Let's go ahead and do this practice scrimmage, first team versus second team. 21, you know, street rules. Make practices mean something. 5 points, boost to everything, you know. And it ain't even gotta be everything. Like I said, just team awareness, team chemistry. So affect the awareness, because I don't think that's an attribute. That's not an attribute to the players. So affect the players, attribute, offensive attribute, like offensive awareness, defense awareness. Maybe stamina, endurance, maybe. You know, a little stuff like that. Hustle. Depending on how well they did in the live scrimmage. Ooh, got him. Right now, Tony Roten is my starting point guard, but he's injured. So I got Shabazz Napier as my point guard. Look at that dude, get in his face, be in his chest. Ooh. Oh. Good D, Turner. Although he warped into position. Other shoulder. Ooh. Ooh. Oh. He almost left him. Should be an eye for an eye thing. Star players going back and forth. There we go. Just add more emotion to the game. Get some more personality and attitude in the game. I mean, we know it's a game already, but they ain't gotta feel like robots. Nice. With the contact. Flex. He should flex right there. Should be like and one, or should be looking to the referee for a foul. Something. Oh, he open. Ah! Played the other side too close. Trying to keep me from the other side. But you hear, I mean. You hear all that communication. Oh, what was that? I mean, the last practice, not the last one, but the one before that one. All those fouls, those hard fouls, you don't even see that in game. Like, you don't see. I've never seen that, those many hard fouls in game. It's very few. And I'm wondering, is it because of. Oh, he left Paul George. Left Paul George right there. That's my fault. He read that the whole way. I like the fact that they finally started ball tracking. He tracked that one. Tight, dude. Nice. Show something. Show some emotion. Hit a three. He did nothing. Oh. Ah! Get some. Nah, it's quiet. It's quiet, ain't nobody talking. You shut the gym up. Oop. Dang, Brady. That would have been a foul. Push. Oh, almost lost it. Ah. Oh. That was a bad possession. Mm. Wow. Oh. But for some that are new to my series that I do, you know, the show. The EA 2K show is a combination of 2K basketball, 2K wrestling, 2K, I think that's about it. That's all the 2K sport games is out. Get him, George. Ugh. Get some. He ain't want none. EA games like Madden, FIFA, still pondering if I want to jump into that UFC or not. He should have been blocked. This is game right here. Get some, Brady. There it is. Game. Second team is weak. But I got to build up my second team for my Pacers squad. EA, like I said, Madden, hockey. Oh, yeah, hockey. FIFA. Come show my channel some love on YouTube. Starting to really get into this a little bit more and more. Trying to get my editing skills up on par. Not really on the Twitch thing unless I'm doing Forza and that's my paint bills. So check out my YouTube channel, BMW Ninja Gaming. Twitter. Follow me on Twitter, BMW Ninja Gaming at B Sales. It's a little bit of everything. The show, for that network. I do baseball, and I got my No Guts, No Glory series, which is a bunch of different shooters. So come check your boy out. Come check the channel out. See what the channel is about. Thank you for watching this, my wish list for 2K17. Wasn't a lot of wishes, but I think some of the things that could definitely improve the franchise play of the game. Like I said, this screen right here, like it's boring. It's not much going on. I thought the ticker bar would be going, but it's not going. Maybe because it's just too much information. I mean, you got this coach plan where you can set up a gameplay for. Or set up the roster for each team, which is a nice touch. But I feel like this stuff right here, like you set these parameters, you set this stuff up, and it's not even really, it's not used. It's not used at all. Especially if you simulate a game, like my second option is Militant. He's not my second option in stat-wise, or even shots, so. I don't. They should definitely, if the coaches implement the coaches playbook and make sure that coach is running that playbook, you should definitely see it in game while you're playing that team. Like, man. So if you went from playing the Phoenix Suns and they were slow and grind, that coach got fired and he went to another team, and you're playing his team, you should see that team using that same playbook. Phoenix Suns shouldn't be running that same playbook. Because that coach got fired, unless there's another coach who's running that same playbook. League news, I never really paid that much attention to it. If there was another way they could, I mean, you get the league news right here. If there's another way they can do it, they should definitely do it. Maybe go back to the old 2K, was that 12? No, 11? Where the home screen, it showed you the top story, and then it went through all of them to show you what was going on around the league or whatever. Something like that, maybe bring that concept back. Stats. I mean, they trying to show more and more stats. Records. I don't know how they could improve or implement more records, but they should somehow. Like I said, I'm not the game developer. training, we already talked about that. Practice should definitely have more impact in game. If you do the practice, you should have your team rewarded for doing the practice instead of just feeling like it's not. Actually, sometimes when you do the practice, it seems like it's a negative against your team because they'll either end up getting hurt the following game, which blows my mind. talked about the draft. You should be able to edit these players throughout the draft. So if you're one of those people that don't like taking, or if you haven't been able to get the chance of grabbing a community draft roster, you can edit the draft throughout the season and make it to your liking. That should come back. Editing the players. Relocation and team branding. Add some more designs, maybe. Add some more logos to the court. When you go in-game, have it be recognized. Because if it's not recognized, if the show up title screen, the match screen, does it recognize it? And you're just looking at a blank side versus the Rockets. What is that? What is that? Or if your team got the team colors on, or you know your team colors, but your team is wearing a primary team color and then the secondary color is a gray. Or some weird pink color. What is that? The cheerleaders are wearing off-brand shoes. and they don't have a logo on their chest, or the fans in the stands don't have a logo or team colors. What is that? Just make it more realistic. If I'm able to get team branding, let me use the team branding, and it should be plastered all over the place. And that's it. So thank you for watching. If you didn't get to catch all of it, hop over there to my YouTube channel. Once again, BMW Ninja Gaming. Leave me some comments. Let me know what you're thinking, how you feel about what I was saying. Short wish list, but it is a wish list. Just a couple things to improve the game. So, on that note, I'll see you guys later.